Sister to Israel, which does not bother with any such balancing acts. It seems to have its priorities straight. Topping the list is national security, and to secure that, Israel goes to any lengths. Their enemy number one is the Islamic Republic of Iran. Now, fun facts, Iran and Israel do not share borders. Iran and Israel have no territorial disputes. Yet Iran and Israel remain at loggerheads, blame religion and ideology. Iran opposes the very existence of Israel. It says Israel has illegally occupied Palestinian land. They've exchanged multiple threats over the years to fire to war. Last month, we saw more of the same. Iran threatened to strike the heart of Israel if it made the slightest of moves against Tehran. These were the exact words of Ibrahim Raisi, the Iranian president. Do you know what's Israel's response? They're planning to practice a military strike on Iran. They'll carry out drills, simulating strikes on the Iranian regime. They're calling this exercise the Chariots of Fire. Reports say it will be the largest military drill in Israel's history. What does it hope to achieve? Three things. Number one, maintain a high level of readiness. Number two, improve Israel's military capabilities. And three, prepare for a multi-front and prolonged war on all its borders. Israel says this exercise was required because the threat from Iran is growing. The country's leadership, its military, its media, they've all been warning Israel of an impending war. Let me show you what an Iranian mouthpiece did a few months back. It published a map of Israel riddled with mountains. The message was clear. Iran would strike Israel whenever it wants, wherever it wants. And attached with this was a four-word warning. Just one wrong move. That's what it said. Just one wrong move. A couple of weeks later, the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps issued a threat and said it was going to launch a fight against quote-unquote international Zionism. Now, this was a direct reference to Israel's global influence, international Zionism. Now, given these warnings, Israel says it's not taking any chances, it cannot afford to, it's already struggling with domestic unrest. There are clashes underway in Jerusalem. They've been on for the last 2 months. The situation is precarious. The warnings from Iran are adding to their worries. So these drills are aimed at sending a message that Israel is prepared to combat all threats, internal and external. The drills will begin on the 29th of May, that's less than 2 weeks from now. What are they planning to do with these drills? Israel has laid out an exhaustive plan. This is what they say they'll do. All units of Israel's defense forces will take part in the drills. They will focus on fighting along Israel's northern border, including a possible battle with the Iran-backed Hezbollah movement in Lebanon. A large number of Israeli fighter jets will also take part in the drill, and they will be provided with a stream of targets by Israel's target-generating intel unit. Now, these targets will be compiled based on intelligence intercepts from Iran. Israel says the simulated targets will not just be Iranian facilities, but also strategic units located deep underground. The U.S. Air Force will also help Israel refuel its fighter jets mid-air during these drills. So yes, America will participate in these drills. Israel practices striking Iran. In fact, the chief of the U.S. Army Central Command is already in Israel to prepare for the drills. His name is General Michael Kurilla. He landed in Tel Aviv on Tuesday. Remember, this comes at a time when nuclear talks with Iran have hit a roadblock. Iranian officials have refused to curtail their missile program. The war in Ukraine has complicated things further. At a time like this, the U.S. will attempt drills aimed at Iran. What kind of message does this send? We understand Israel's fears. It faces an existential threat from Iran, it says. But what about the Americans? What's in it for them? Chance to make Iran buckle under pressure, perhaps. See concessions in the stalled nuclear talks. Will the strategy work, or will it provoke Iran further? That is the question. VEON is now available in your country. Download the app now and get